you're looking for cheap and easy DIY projects and crafts, we've got a video for you. Are you new around here? Be sure to subscribe to Crafty Hackers for our newest hacks and click the thumbs up button if you like this video. Now check out these easy, cheap DIY crafts. You're going to love the DIY photo album at the end. Let's get started. Case for headphones. Don't you hate it when your headphones get all tangled up? Here's a quick fix. Grab a couple of clothespins. Hot glue them together so that the clips open at opposite ends. Now feed the end of the cord through and wrap it around. Now you won't have to mess with tangled headphones ever again. Ebook case. Get a colorful piece of fabric and measure it to your ebook reader. Fold it over and hot glue the end. Hot glue the opposite side too. Now take a piece of velcro and hot glue it to the front. Attach the other side of the velcro and glue it to the top flap. Hold it until the glue dries. Now, for a decorative flair, get a button or jewel and a lace flower. Glue the jewel to the lace flower. Super cute, right? Perfect fit. Now let's add a pocket to the back side of your case. Cut out a smaller piece of fabric. Pick whatever color you like. Hot glue a seam on the side and add more glue to the outside of the seam so that you can glue it to your case. Now do the same for the other side. Now you've got a pocket for your headphones. That was super easy. Decor for scarves. Take a piece of wood and about 4 cups. You're going to hot glue the bottom of the cups on the wood, like this. Let them set. And enjoy your cute accessible holder for your scarves, hats, and gloves. You'll be able to see them and grab them when you need them as you head out the door. Candle holder. You can find inexpensive picture frames at the dollar store or at a secondhand store. Watch how we turn them into a stylish candle holder. Take the frame apart and remove the back. Then hot glue the glass to the frame. Do this with 4 picture frames. Now we're going to make a box by gluing the frames together. Start with 1 corner and work your way around until you have a glass box shape. Now take the cardboard backing of the frame and remove all the extra pieces. Cut it to size and glue it onto the bottom of your candle box, like this. Put a candle inside and enjoy your DIY candle holder. Decor. This is just a plain old cheese grater, right? Think again. Here's how you can turn it into a lovely decoration in a few quick steps. Grab some artificial flowers from the dollar store. Feed the stems through the holes in the cheese grater. Thread them back once more so that the ends are on the inside. Now you've got an unconventional flower vase. You can use thumbtacks to hang it up on a wall or corkboard. Use magnets to add pictures, notes, and other decorations. Nice! You can even use the handle to hang items with the clothespin. Silver ball. You guys have seen the aluminum foil ball that's trending all over social media, right? Well, here's a quick and easy way to make your own. Take a large sheet of aluminum foil and carefully fold it in, making a small ball like this. Use a hammer to bang out the points and edges as you go. Keep rolling, forming and pounding with your hammer. The hammer really condenses the ball, so you'll probably need to start with a lot of aluminum foil. Keep shaping and hammering until you get a decent sized ball. When you're happy with the size, cut the extra foil away with scissors. You can use the wooden end of the hammer to refine the aluminum and make it smooth. Once your ball is formed, hammer away at it until it gets nice and smooth. Once you're happy with the feel of the ball, take some sandpaper and sand the ball to give it a nice polished look. Sand it until you get the desired finished look. Watch it sparkle. Sewing case. Here's how to make a sewing case from an old coffee container. Remove the lid and transfer the coffee into another container. Now cut a sponge to fit inside the lid. Hot glue the sponge into the lid. Now you've got a pin cushion for all your pins. Voila! Now use the container to hold all your thread and other sewing supplies. Attach your pincushion lid to your container. And that's all you have to do. Phone holder. Did you know that you can make a phone holder from the pocket of an old pair of jeans? Watch this. First, cut out the pocket. Use a pair of scissors to cut all the way around the back pocket of the jeans. Now that your pocket is cut out, get a piece of string. Turn the pocket inside out and glue the string to the sides of the pocket, like this. Turn the pocket right side out. Now you've got a holder that can hang on the outlet while it's charging. Flip-flop decor. You can usually find a bunch of colorful flip-flops at the dollar store. Here's a way to turn them into a decoration for your home. Grab about 3 pairs of flip-flops and organize them into a circle in a pattern you like. Now, hot glue the heels of the flip-flops together. Do this all the way around your circle. Let the glue set. Then, add some hot glue to the top of the seams. You're going to glue some decorative string on. Wrap the string around and tie it in place. Now do the same for the other seams. Keep wrapping and tying until you've got string attached to all of the seams. Glue on some artificial flowers and hang it on your wall. Cutting board decor. You can make an awesome decoration with just a plain wooden cutting board and some leaves. Here's how. Arrange the leaves on your cutting board and spray paint on top of them. Make sure you do this outside or in a well-ventilated area. After the paint dries, remove the leaves and check it out. You've got a cool design for your wall. Bookmark. Measure a bit of ribbon to fold inside of your book. Now you're going to glue the end of the ribbon around a rubber band. Do the same for the other end of the ribbon. Slide it onto the back cover of your book, like this. Earring holder. You can make an earring holder with colored popsicle sticks. Just hot glue them into this design. Use 2 more popsicle sticks to prop it up from the back. Glue them into place. After the glue dries, hang your favorite earrings onto your new holder. Isn't it cool? Cables holder. Tangled cables can be a pain in the neck. Here's a stylish way to keep them organized. Cut a paper towel roll in half. Or use 2 toilet paper rolls. Get some decorative tape and wrap it around the holder. Do this with as many designs as you like until you get to the end. Doesn't that look nice? Now, fold up your cable and place it inside the holder. This makes it easy to store, and it's pretty. Pencil holder. We're going to turn this yogurt container into a fun, fancy pencil holder. Check it out. Empty the container and wash it. Find some pretty rope and hot glue the end to the bottom of the container. Wrap the rope around until you get it to about 1 inch from the top. Hot glue the other end into place. Next, measure a length of ribbon to fit the top of the cup. Hot glue the ribbon into place. Now you've got a stylish pencil holder for your desk. Photo album. You can transform an old matchbox into a photo album. It's easy. Pull off the cover and cut the side. Now you've just created a top for your album. Hot glue the cover to the matchbox, then glue the back on. Cut a small piece of velcro. Glue one end to the matchbox and the other end to the top flap. You've just made a fastener. With a ruler, measure the size of the box. Cut a thick piece of paper according to the measurements of the box. fold the box-sized pieces in an accordion fold. This is going to be where you attach your photos. Select your favorite pictures and cut them into the size of your holder. Use double-sided tape to attach the pictures to the album. Keep going until you've covered all the accordion foils with photos. Next, add another piece of double-sided tape to the top of your album, and another piece on the bottom. Stick it into the box and fasten it closed. Pull the top open when you want to show your friends your pictures. Pretty cool, right? And those were our cheap and easy DIY projects and crafts. Let us know which one was your favorite in the comments below. Thanks for watching, Crafty Hackers. See you later.